3 a.m.
Yeah, yeah, sorry to bother you. I know it's late, or early, or both, but this is quite important.
Right.
Yeah, well, basically, I've had some complaints.
About the party?
No, not about the party. I've had some complaints in the last 30 seconds or so. Well, Mona, they're about you. The noise in this flat is far too much. And I don't want to do this, because I'm your friend, as well as your landlady. And, well, I own the place, and if I had to kick you to the curb, then do you know what I'm saying?
You know the noise isn't coming from here, right? It's coming from the party upstairs. It's been keeping me up all night.
Mona, dear, my gathering of my closest and dearest confidants is hardly that offensive to your ears, is it? Anyway, thank you, darling. Have a good night.
Mona? Mona?
Hey, Charlie.
How was your weekend?
Sleepless. I have the weirdest neighbors.
I went scuba diving in Nice.
Cool.
And my brother got married.
Oh, wow.
Did you hear Mark got fired?
Mark got fired? When? Why?
No idea. But the new boss is starting today, apparently. She's this jack of all trades, 30 under 30, young girl boss type. And our age, supposedly.
Only 20?
It's rude to talk about a woman's age.
Vivian!
Hi.
What are you doing here?
New job. I'm afraid you'll have to put up with me a little more than usual. Young man, could you get a stool or a chair or some object that I could stand on that would make me look above everyone? Thanks.
Okay.
Thanks. Right, now that I have you all here, a little bit closer at the back, sorry. I, Vivian Anderson, am the new executive manager of Apollo Printers Limited. I want you to know that every inch of my being, every fibre of my being, my soul will go into this job. So help me God. We will persist. We will reach heights that no printing company has ever reached before. Godspeed. Godspeed.
Hi.
Hi.
Can I speak with you in my office in a minute? Yeah? Okay, yeah. Thank you. Sorry, just some paperwork. It's all digital now, isn't it?
I suppose so. Why did you want to see me?
Oh, this is strange, isn't it?
Well, it was surprising to see you, but I'm glad you've got the job. You've been much more accommodating than most other people.
I am. But I can't always be. I can't always be nice to you, Mona, just because we're friends as well as work colleagues.
Yeah, I don't expect you to.
Of course you don't. Which is why I'm going to have to ask you to go home.
Why?
Darling, that skirt. It's shorter than the time it took me to climb Kilimanjaro at 8 years old, for which I won a Guinness World Record. It has to change. I know you're, you know, eyeing up that hot stud, but this is a workplace environment. Thanks, I knew you'd understand. Thank you, honey.
Before we met,
stayed at home and gone to bed. I could have gone to see a film instead. You might have changed your mind and seen from but then.
Enjoying the party?
Yeah.
Good. Like the new skirt?
Thank you. Yeah, it's all great.
Oh, slurring your words a bit, are we? Whoa, careful!
Oh, careful!
Careful! Someone's had a bit too much to drink, I think! No. Anyway.
Vivian!
Let's sit you down, Mom.
Vivian!
You've had enough!
I'm fine! Hey, I'm fine!
Are you alright?
Yeah!
Mona, I fucking told you to stop drinking and now look what you've done. You've got alcoholic beverage all over our confidential and very fucking important balls.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
This disgraceful behaviour, I have no choice. I am forced to terminate you right here, right now, in front of all your friends and colleagues.
The caterer pushed me.
Joe is my nephew and I will not have a bad word said about him.
He still pushed me.
He provided a scrumptious luncheon for your gastronomical pleasure. Is this how you repay him? Is this how you repay me? After the home I provided, does that mean nothing to you? Get out! Leave!
Are you serious?
Yeah! Get out!
Too easy, but that's the way it is. What you think about that?